Hello and welcome to a new type of video for this channel. Rather than give another drum corps lesson, in this video we will go over the requirements for the Drumming and Percussion Pathfinder Honor. There are already some resources available to assist with the honor, but I found a few that were either misleading or incomplete, and since I've done several videos on drum corps lessons, I thought it was time to include the honor on this channel. While this is not called the Drum Corps Honor, it is fairly evident that drum corps is the intent behind this honor based on the requirements. Honor requirements sometimes change, so keep that in mind if you're viewing this a few years down the road. As of right now, there are 15 requirements in the Drumming and Percussion Honor. The first one is, write a one-page paper demonstrating your knowledge of how a drum corps can be used to minister within your local church and community. You're on your own as far as writing the paper, but I'll share some ideas from my experience. The church I was attending several years ago had a church picnic on a Sunday in early August, and the Pathfinder Club took the summer off. So when lunch was being served, we had the drum corps start playing from a few hundred feet away and marched into the food area, obviously grabbing everyone's attention. We then made the announcement that Pathfinder registration would be coming up soon and we'd love for you to join us. Then we played and marched out. Maybe this was not a true ministry event, but we used it to support our Pathfinder ministry. If appropriate, you could use the drum corps in connection with Vacation Bible School programs. They could be the band that played during the story of the fiery furnace, as long as you explain that it was actually a full band and not a drum corps. Same thing for marching around Jericho, just let them know it was actually trumpets. A third way that I have done is to have the drum corps march into the church on Sabbath of Memorial Day or even Veterans Day weekend. Not every church or conference will be comfortable with playing in the sanctuary, so this may not be an option. I've been in both settings. But I have marched in with my drum corps on Memorial Day Sabbath, and then had the roll call for all the veterans that were there within the church membership. As far as ministering within the community, one way is for the Pathfinder Club to march in the local Veterans Day parade. I have done that where we actually invited the entire Pathfinder district to join us, even got the official conference banner from our area coordinator. So we had the conference banner up front, then the flags, then the drum corps, which captured everyone's attention, and then all the Pathfinders in the district, four wide and many, many rows deep. 2. What are the four families of rudiments? Ironically, one of the topics I had set aside for a video on drum corps was on rudiments. The four families of rudiments are rolls, diddles, flams, and drags. And while this may sound like the name of some obscure law firm, it's actually just the name of the four families of rudiments. Rolls are just what you're already thinking they are, a continuous rolling sound that is most often performed on the snare but can be done on any of the instruments. Diddles are a unique technique where you play the sound twice with the same hand. They are normally played as 16th notes where you're alternating the right and left hand, but for a diddle, you play two consecutive 16th notes with the same hand. The result of this will change which hand starts each beat. Diddles are used on all drums, but perhaps are most necessary on the multi-tom. A quick example of the diddle is the single paradiddle, which is played right, left, right, right, left, right, left, left, and repeat. Flams are where you add a single low-volume note, called a grace note, immediately before the primary note. Shown here are quarter-note flams. Drags are very similar to flams, but there are two grace notes before the primary note. Shown here are quarter-note drags. 3. Be able to name 5 rudiments from each of the 4 families of rudiments. 5 of the rudiments in the rolls family include single-stroke roll, double-stroke roll, triple-stroke roll, multiple-bounce roll, 5-stroke roll, and as you can see, many others. For diddles, I'm not sure how you can learn 5 rudiments from each family when there are only a total of 4 diddle rudiments. And those are single paradiddle, double paradiddle, triple paradiddle, and paradiddle diddle. Why does that sound like a child's nursery rhyme? 5 of the rudiments in the flam family include all those you see on the screen, such as flam, flam accent, flam paradiddle, Swiss Army triplet, and flam drag. And lastly, in the drag family of rudiments, 5 examples would include any of these, such as drag, single drag tap, single dragadiddle, lesson 25, and single rademacue. 4. Demonstrate ability to keep in step with the drum corps by taking part in at least one outreach program, example, Pathfinder Day, conference, or local church-sponsored event. You will need to be part of a drum corps and participate in order to accomplish this. Marching that Veterans Day, for example, will give you that opportunity. 5. What is the difference between drum carriers and drum straps? demonstrate with drum equipment in formation. A carrier is rigid and holds the drum in a fixed place in front of your body. A strap is cloth that holds the weight of the drum, but the drum rests against your body. 6. What are the 7 essential rudiments? Why are they essential? The 7 essential rudiments are not specific to drum corps or pathfinders. They are used by all drummers of all styles. They are single stroke roll, multiple bounce roll, double stroke open roll, 5-stroke roll, single paradiddle, flam, and drag. These 7 rudiments include the variety of different playing techniques that can be built into virtually all other rudiments and techniques. 7. What is the difference between playing open versus closed? Playing open is playing a specific number of notes, such as 2 hits of a double stroke roll or 3 hits of a triple stroke roll. Playing closed is playing with multiple bounces but no prescribed number, such as the multiple bounce roll. Both will alternate hands, but playing open will have a defined number of hits per hand, while playing closed will not. For example, the sticking for a 5-stroke roll is right, left, right. You can double stroke it or make it open by playing right, right, left, left, right. You can buzz it or make it a closed roll, right, left, right, where the first 2 notes are buzzed. 8. Using the open-closed method, demonstrate your knowledge of the 7 rudiments. Execute open to close to open. In lesson 5, you saw me play 32nd notes, where I started very slowly and gradually sped up to where it was a roll and then slowed it back down again. When playing open to open, it's the same thing, except where you get the true roll at maximum speed, you switch to a closed style or a multiple bounce roll. 9. What is the difference between traditional style and match style stick holding? Demonstrate each style by playing a sequence consisting of no less than 3 rudiments. Match grip is where both hands grip the stick the same way. They match. Traditional grip is based on drummers from generations ago where snare drums were slung over the shoulder and one side was much higher than the other. The drummers had to create a technique of how to play this uneven surface, and thus the traditional grip was born. Today, it has just stuck around. While it does allow for a different technique, even most drummers that prefer traditional grip will agree that it's not superior, but rather just a preference. 10. What is the difference between drumsticks used for drum corps and those used for a percussion drum set? Drum corps sticks are thicker than those used on a drum set. I have a collection of both since I've been playing the set for longer than I've been with a drum corps. Also, drum corps uses mallets for bass and a version of mallets for multi-toms. So the main difference for the sticks themselves is that the drum corps sticks are thicker since the drum corps typically play at a higher volume than a drum set, also because they tend to hit harder. A drummer on a kit may want to use maximum volume, but the thicker and heavier drum corps sticks will cause some added resistance if rapidly moving around the kit. 11. What are the sections that make up drum corps? One area where I differ from the answers on the Wiki Answers website for this honor is that I do not include a pit section. I, like most Pathfinder drum corps that I've seen, use a cymbal section, snare section, multi-tom section, and a bass section. 12. Based on the previous question, what purpose does each section serve? Cymbals provide energy and enhance a crescendo. Cymbal players can add the visual aspect of performance by twirling cymbals and adding other choreography. Snare drums are perhaps the most recognizable aspect of the drum corps, and frequently the lead snare drummer is the leader of the drum corps. Quite often the drum corps music features the snare drums, with the other sections filling out the music. Multitoms add pitch to the music with their ability to play on multiple tone drums, called toms. Some people refer to the multitoms as tenors. Bass drums make up the foundation of the tempo, even though the lead snare drum may start the music by counting off. Larger drum corps will have several bass drums with different sizes, each size having its own music part while still working together as a bass drum section. 13. Show the various types of protective devices used to secure drum corps equipment. To be completely honest, I have no idea what this requirement is talking about. Even the Wiki Honors website have this one blank. The only need to secure drum corps equipment is to the drum carrier, which we already discussed, or the cymbal to the strap or handle. Requirement 5 referred to carriers and straps, and this requirement uses the term protective devices, so it must be something other than those. I even did a Google search for drum corps protective devices, and the only thing I could even draw from that was earplugs, but those do not secure drum corps equipment. 14. What are the various types and sizes of drumsticks used for a drum corps? While drum set sticks are commonly known by a letter and number, drum corps sticks are bigger and usually not found in those formats. Only the largest of the common drum set sticks, the 2B, would I ever even consider using in a drum corps. Here is a 2B, and here are some drum corps sticks. The types of drumsticks include sticks for the snare, mallets for the multi-toms, and different mallets for the bass. Here are some multi-tom mallets. And here are some bass drum mallets. 15. Know what tools and equipment use for drum corps practice sessions. Drumsticks, of course. Also can use a practice pad rather than a drum so as to control the volume. There are various types of practice pads. Here are two of them. One has two sides of different material. The gray side has more bounce to it, thus making it easier to play. The black side is hard and does not bounce as well, so I prefer to use the black side as it forces me to use good technique in order to get the free stroke. The other practice pad uses an actual drum head, so it plays more like a real snare drum. Other ones are practice pads that go right onto the drums to mute them so that you can still play a drum, it just won't make as much noise. And that's it for the requirements to the Pathfinder Drumming and Percussion Honor. If you have any questions, comments, or know what requirement 13 was talking about, feel free to use the comments section of this video.